Hi, Chris Good here. We're going to take another look at the chart builder and do some graphs of types that we didn't get to in class. So the first one is called a population pyramid, and it's basically a histogram, but you can split it by group. So the data file that I'm working with is called Jiminy Cricket. So if you open that up from the DSUS4 data folder, Jiminy Cricket, there it is. And you can start the chart builder by clicking on the graphs menu. So if we open chart builder, we'll get our preview window here. And it is in the histogram. The population pyramid is in the histograms. If you hover over it, you'll get a little mouse over ID, population pyramid. All you have to do is drag the gallery chart into the preview window and set it down. And then there's two things that you have to drag variables to. We're going to use strategy for success as the split variable, right? And that will determine what goes on which side of the population pyramid. And the y-axis here is going to be the level of success after the intervention. So success post, and if you drag that into there, we're gonna leave the rest of the element properties here set to their default, automatic bend sizes, automatic first bend anchor, and hit apply to that. And if we close that window and hit okay, we should get an output graph, and there it is. So this is a good way of looking at distributions that are split by a grouping variable. That's the population pyramid. And the next type of graph we're gonna look at is a clustered bar chart with error bars. And so we're gonna open a new data document. We're gonna go back to the chick flick data. That's not chick flick mixed. Make sure you choose chickflick.sav. If you open that, we're interested in arousal ratings, and we're going to split first by gender and then by the name of the film. Alright, so if we choose clustered bar chart, here, right? We're going to, on the x-axis, that's going to be the name of the film, right? So we're going to have separate clusters for the film, and then we're going to color the bars on each axis by gender. And again, we're measuring the arousal. I do want to have error bars, so I'm going to click on this element properties menu that opened to display the 95% confidence interval, and just check that we are graphing the mean here. Hit apply, and you'll get a little preview there that doesn't represent the actual data, but if you hit OK, we should get our clustered error bar chart. All right, so one more thing. If we had repeated measures, you have to do something a little bit different to get a bar chart. Let's open the hiccups data. So these are different treatments for hiccups, different hiccups cures. So if you open that file and start chart builder, we want to do a simple bar chart. And we have multiple measures here, but they're from the same people. So baseline and then these other methods of curing hiccups. If you highlight all of these and drag them all to the y-axis, this little plus sign pops up. And when you drop them there, you get a new menu here that says create summary group, and it says that it's going to create a new variable that's assigned to the y-axis. And if you hit OK, it'll create category labels for the x-axis. And let's go ahead and choose the 95% confidence interval error bars. And we'll hit apply. All right, and we'll see what this graph looks like. So by dragging all those variables into the y-axis, we see that we've created this new summary variable that will name the different categories, different treatments for this repeated measures data, the within subjects data. All right, last thing that we want to talk about is a scatterplot matrix. And we're going to use a data file that is the exam anxiety. All right, so if you open up exam anxiety and go back to the chart builder and click on scatter/dot plots, we already looked at how to make a grouped scatter plot, setting the color of the dots by gender and looking at the relationship between, for example, exam anxiety and time spent revising. That's British for studying, by the way. If we plot that, let's just remind ourselves that we need to open the chart editor in order to add fit lines. So we can add a single fit line to all the data or split separate fit lines. Just use the default there. When you close the chart editor, see it plotted separate linear regression lines for men and women. We're going to do something a little bit different and do something called a scatterplot matrix. And that's this item here. So if you ever get lost, just hover your mouse and it'll tell you what these things are. We're going to drag scatterplot matrix into the preview window, and we're going to select these three different variables, time spent revising, exam performance, and exam anxiety. If you highlight all three of those, all three, and you drag them into the x-axis, you get another plus there, right? And it's going to plot these variables against each other, so all possible combinations of these. You're going to get separate scatter plots for each one. Let's take a look at what that looks like. We'll hit OK, go back to our output document. All right, so now we have three variables plotted against those three variables, and you'll see that across the diagonal here we get blank boxes. Well, that's because we get a scatter plot of time spent revising against, well, itself. So those would line up in a perfectly straight line. Similarly, exam performance correlates with exam performance perfectly, and they just don't bother to plot that perfectly straight line. All the other graphs, and you'll see that some of them are repeated, we have exam performance correlates with time spent revising, and you'll see that this is actually the exact same graph sort of rotated a bit, of time spent revising correlated with exam performance. So if we double click on this, we can fit linear regression lines to each one of these scatter plots, and it does automatically. When you close it, it'll replot, and we've got our regression lines for each one. Okay, that is about it for graphs. So we will see you next time.